Hi friend, today we are going to discuss one more important topic, that is the Miller indices. So this Miller indices, it is very very important for in crystallography, for material science persons, for electronics persons or mathematics persons. So in this Miller indices, there are two methodologies which are used. One is that on the basis of planes, we can determine the Miller indices. And second thing is that on the basis of Miller indices, we can determine plane in a particular crystals. So we will see one by one. Suppose this is the one cubic structure, and so this is the in 3D format, this is the front view of this one, front face, and this is the back face of this particular cube. So in this case, there are particularly three axes. This is the x axis, this is the y axis, and this is the z axis. These are the three axes. And in this structure, we followed right-handed coordinate system. So this is the right-handed coordinate system. Okay, so this is the source. From source towards the x, this is the x positive, this is y positive, and this is the z positive. From source to x, this is the positive. From source to its backside, opposite of this x, it is negative. From source to y, it is positive. And from source to backside of this, or opposite of this y, this is negative. And from source to this z, this is the positive z, and exact towards downwards to the source, it is negative z. So this is the right-handed coordinate system. So this indices system is determined or discovered by the Miller. Miller, he was a British crystallographer, and he discovered the system of the giving a particular value to the particular plane. So it is a mathematical notations, and each plane has its own value, physical quantity, and that can be determined on the basis of these indices, or plane has its different value. For example, suppose this is a plane, this is one plane. This plane has different values, and another plane is this one. These two planes have different value in this indices system. This plane has different indices, and this plane has also different indices. Now we will take one example. So first we will see one example. Suppose in Miller indices, there are three steps which are very very important. One is the intercepts, then followed by reciprocal, and third one is simplification. If reciprocal are not simple, then make it simple. If they are simple, there is no need to make its simplification. Okay, we will take one example. Suppose this is the cube, this is the front view, and this is the back face of this cube. So this is the x axis, this is the y axis, and this is the z axis. So now if we take point on x axis, here the intercepts are half. Then we will take second point on y-axis. This is again intercepts are 1 by 2. If you take a third point z-axis, that is the 1 by 2. So these are the intercepts on this particular axis. When we join this point, there is a formation of plane. And we have to draw the indices of this particular plane. So now what we have to do? We know the intercepts of this particular point on this plane. Now second thing, take the reciprocal of these intercepts. So it may be 2, 2, 2, 1 by 2. It can make 2 by 1, 2 by 1, 2 by 1. Now make it simplify. So all these values divided by 2. So it may be 1, 1, 1. So the indices of this plane is 1, 1, 1. So this is the Miller indices, and they are putted or written in the parenthesis. And when we are talking about this Miller indices, each and every time they written as 1, 1, 1, not 111. So this is one example. We will take second example. Suppose, for example, if the Miller indices, on the basis of Miller indices, we can draw plane also. We will take one example. Suppose Miller indices are 1, 1, 1. Then it means this plane. See, suppose this is the source. From source to this point, this is 1 on the x-axis. So, on the x-axis. On y-axis, this point, this is 1. X-axis 1, y-axis 1, and z-axis, this is the 1. Make it simplification. There is no need to simplify. Now, we have to reciprocal it. When we take reciprocal of this one, it is again same 1 by 1, 1 by 1, 1 by 1, 1 by 1. So, the intercepts are 1, 1, 1. The plane, when we draw this plane, the plane will be like this, and it is exact parallel to the earlier plane. So the Miller indices of one plane is similar to the other plane also. But these two planes are parallel to each other. In that case only, such type of indices are there. Now we will take third example. So suppose this is a cube. Okay. So what we have to do? Suppose we have to determine the Miller indices. We have to draw Miller indices of this particular face, front face of this crystal model. Okay. So now what we have to do? Source is here. This is the x-axis. This is the y-axis, and this is the z-axis. These are the three axes, as we are known about that one. So now from 0 to this place, so this is the 1. Then second is that this plane is parallel to the y-axis. So therefore it is infinity. This is the x, y, and z. Now third thing, this z axis is also parallel to the z axis. So therefore it is again infinity. So now we have to make reciprocal of this one. So 1 divided by 1, reciprocal of this y axis. It is again 1 by 0, 1 by 0. It means that this y-axis and z-axis never intersects to this particular plane. So that's why. So it is 1, 0, 1 by 0. So it is 1, 0, 0.
The Miller indices of this particular plane is 100. So here the indices of this plane is 100. Now we will take another example. On the basis of Miller indices, we have to draw a particular any plane. Suppose Miller indices are 101. On the basis of this indices value, if we have to draw a plane in particular crystal, how it looks? Suppose this is a plane. So this is the z axis, this is the x axis, and this is the y axis. Now indices are given to you, we have to make simplify it. So how it can be? Suppose, so make it simplify. So 10, so it may be 1, 0 is infinity, and again 1. Okay, so this is the intercept. So intercepts are 1, infinity 1. So on x axis, this is the point 1. On y axis, it is parallel to this y axis, and on z axis it is again 1. So here this is point. So when we connect these two points, so plane will be like this. This plane has a Miller indices value, that is the 101. If we take, suppose this is source, one thing is again important in this Miller indices. If you consider this is a source toward this side, when we are drawing a such plane or Miller indices of that any plane, so there are negative values, -101. When we write in indices form, it should be (1, 0, 1). It is in parenthesis. And always the Miller indices are denoted by letter H, K, L. H for this X axis, K for this Y axis, and L for this Z axis. There is no any comma in between these two. So I hope this indices system useful to you. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in comments box. If you like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is GeoEntire, all about there.